I mean, it's obviously it's a tournament that I want to win the most, and it's a tournament. You know, the tournament. The only way to win is if you play and have a chance. But this is one of those moments where you look back on life and you just don't want to miss it. You want to. I'll be really glad that I was there and present.
Well, obviously, I want to talk a little bit of Phil here. Surprise, surprise, I'd like to talk about Phil Mickelson. But I don't know what you're taking from this. I find it interesting. You know, I'm not going to obviously say anything negative about Phil's decision. He's always been a family man first, and this is his daughter's graduation. However, this is the most important tournament to Phil, the one he wants the most. I'm going to try to take maybe a bit of a different angle here, Bob. The rest of us are counting the clock, father time, on Phil Mickelson and his opportunity to the U.S. Open. Is it reasonable to suggest that maybe that's just the rest of us? And with Phil's decision, it tells us that he still thinks he has lots of time and there's going to be multiple opportunities to win this championship, or he wouldn't be making this decision?
You know, it's a hard one. There's a lot of guys who would not make this decision. A lot of players would say, I'm sorry, dear, I'm going to miss your valedictorian address. But I think for Phil, yeah, I think Phil still thinks he has lots in the tank. I think he still feels he can play well. He's still been very competitive, even though he hasn't really notched that win since 2013. But I still think for him, this is all about perspective. There's going to be a U.S. Open next year. There's not going to be a graduation for my daughter anytime again. So I think this is a good move for Phil, and I think you can only applaud him.